They play for the thrill of victory. They play for the agony of defeat. The pocket aces. Chasing. Bluffing. But most of all,
I play for kids with muscular dystrophy.
I'm all in for a cure for cancer.
I'm all in for kids with autism.
Be sure to tune in to the next broadcast of Windy City Poker Championship right here on Comcast Sportsnet Chicago.
I'm all in.
Tonight on Windy City Poker Championship, players from all across the globe have come to play poker to benefit the Bethel-Imani Lutheran Church. Welcome once again to the Windy City Poker Championship. I'm Michael Lapidus alongside Kirk Falla. We're back here at Grace O'Malley's in the South Loop, where we've been watching over 50 poker players compete to be the Windy City Poker Champion.
That's right, Michael. We've seen a lot of action early and witnessed some pretty big hands already. It seems the big calls have paid off for many of the players, and the quick all-ins have left others disappointed.
Well, now we're heading into this final table, and if these six players stay as hot as the cards have been, we should see some more amazing hands. But before the cards are dealt, let's meet these players.
In position number one is Joe Lacosto. He's a paramedic from Chicago, loves playing in charity poker tournaments, and has been playing poker for more than 10 years now. He's currently third in chips with $28,800. Next to Joe in position number two is Ron Hevron, a consultant from Chicago. He's currently fourth in chips with $14,600. In position number three is Hakan Gunja. Hakan is from Turkey. He considers himself an average poker player. He is currently the short stack with 9,600 in chips. In position number four is Daniel Quiros, but you can call him Danny. A graphic designer from Chicago, he's a big fan of Star Wars. Danny hopes the Force will be with him tonight. He is currently fifth in chips with 11,400. To Danny's left in position number five is our current chip leader, Chris Croft, a Californian who we think came to town to be in our television show. He currently has $57,000 in chips. And in the final seat, position number six is Erion Postoli. He brought a few lucky charms with him. He's a travel agent who's from Albania. He's second in chips with $33,100.
The Chip Leaderboard brought to you tonight by the LaGrange Business Association. With urban soul and vintage charm, LaGrange offers something for the whole family.
Well, blinds are at $1,000 and $2,000 with a $300 chip ante.
I'll take water too. Thanks for your time.
You guys should do like an awesome watch rental.
Well, Ron seems to like the designer watches we're giving away to tonight's winner.
Arion, first to act.
Actions to Joe on the WPT boot camp pocket camera. He's got Motown, Jack 5. He folds.
Chop.
No, Daniel, you can't chop the pot in the tournament.
I raise.
He raises it, makes it 4,000 to go.
And now Chris Croft, he's our chip leader. He has 9-5 off suit.
He's got the money. I don't know why he wouldn't call $2,000 more to see the flop.
Well, Chris, now you're going to let Daniel just walk away with these blinds.
That whole chopping business, that was a front.
Daniel did just that. He stole the blinds from everyone.
Daniel probably picked up that the table's playing tight and decided to make a move on the chip leader.
It's a combination of skill and luck, which favors everybody who plays. I play really tight in the beginning, and then in the middle stages, I start getting loose, and then once my read is good on people, I just start pegging them off. I came to win. It's a double win. I get to play, and proceeds get to go to a charity.
Let's take a moment to hear from tonight's real winners. Our Alitza Bezios tells us about the Bethel-Imani Lutheran Church.
Jesus, if you are really God, look at all these rocks. I want you to take these rocks and turn it into bread.
I love to pray, it's holy.
Englewood, it is a rough, low-income area. We have a lot of problems with gangs, children just hanging out on the street all the time, nothing for them to do. Here at Bethel, we try to encourage the kids and bring them in, keep them off the streets. Because we have a lot of kids that are just out there, don't know which way to go, which way to turn.
For over 100 years, Bethel-Imani Lutheran Church has been serving the Englewood area. They are a small, close-knit congregation striving to rebuild their community and give their children a place to grow. In the next 5 years, they hope to raise $1 million to build a youth center.
Well, my dream is, first of all, to have a center that will definitely have a basketball court, center that can have volleyball, skating. Also, we have youth night every Friday night. We presently already have an after-school program, and this will be incorporated into the center.
It will give us a place to go after school. It will give us a place, like, to go just to, so we want to just be out in the streets.
I would like playing games, because after school you could go there, probably have fun, but you got to do your homework first, because education comes first.
Members of the Bethel-Imani congregation dream of a place that is safe and supportive so their children can play, study, and grow. A place where they can learn to be kind and compassionate, faithful and loving, honorable and respectful.
I will spend as much time as I can there.
I will go
all day, every day.
If you want to find out more information about the center they're trying to build, you can contact Bethel-Imani by calling 773-487-8136. You can also visit them online at www.bethelimanilutheran.org. Now let's get back to the action here at Grace O'Malley's.
Well, Joe with King 7 off suit, he folds.
Over to Hakan, 10-5, no thank you. Everyone's folding their cards.
Fold. Chris with Jack 8 off suit. He's in the small blind.
How much more?
1,000
to call. Arion with 7-5 of clubs.
Check.
Well, the flop brings 6-9-3.
Now see, that's an amazing flop for Arion. Even though he's behind in the hand, he's got a double gut shot straight draw, a flush draw, and a straight flush draw. So he's favored to win.
Chris checks right away to Arion.
Arion checks as well because he wants to hit his flush, straight, whatever combination you can think of.
Well, this turn is going to be very important for Arion, and it's a jack of hearts.
That card gives Chris a commanding lead with a pair of jacks. Arion, however, still has a lot of cards that can give him the best hand. See, with that misstep by Chris, Arion probably thinks he has a weak hand. Right here is where he should be aggressive and raise it up.
5,000.
And he does. He raises it to 5,000.
Chris calls right away. That has to scare Arion just a bit.
And the river brings the 9 of diamonds.
This gives Chris the best hand right now with jacks and nines. The only way Arion can win this pot is he has to bet and bet aggressively.
6,000.
Well, he's thinking about it. Looks at his cards one more time just to make sure that he has it.
You've got two pair, Chris.
And he is going to put in the 6,000.
Arion does not want to show his hand. Chris slams his hand down and says, I won. Even with that loss, Arion believes his luck here at the final table will change thanks to his lucky charms.
One is from my father, was given to me. I left, I was 18 years old. And this one was given to me from an ex-girlfriend of mine. They're lucky charms. I always wear them when I'm in big poker tournaments and cash games. I will come out here because I love playing poker and I thought it was really well organized, so. And hopefully bring some friends.
Is this a great time?
Yeah.
Oh my God, are you kidding me?
You gotta go?
10 minutes ago.
He's all in, he's gotta go.
Well, these guys have been playing poker for the past 6 hours. They fought hard to get here, and now no one wants to play.
Michael, I want to play. Let me play some poker against these guys. Looking down at the WPT boot camp pocket camera, well, Arion's teasing us a little bit. He shows, I think that's a two of diamonds. We'll call it a two of diamonds.
And with him folding, that gives Joe Lacosto a walk.
We'll be back with more Windy City Poker Championship action right here on Comcast Sportsnet.